Everyone, today I'm going to teach you English grammar's chapter number 3, that is parts of speech. We will be covering the second part of this chapter. As you all know that I have divided this chapter into 2 parts. If you want to know about the first part of this chapter, then I will share you the link in the description. You can go and check over there. If you like this video, then do this video a thumbs up, subscribe to my channel, press the bell icon so that you can get all my videos notification, and share this video with your family and friends too. Let's get started. First of all, I would like to tell you the content of the chapter. In this chapter, we will be quickly revising the definition of parts of speech. Then we will be looking around how many parts of speech are there with the help of their definition and examples. And in the end, we will be looking around the solved exercise of parts of speech. So let's get started. What is parts of speech? The words are divided into different kind according to their use or work in the sentence are known as parts of speech. Okay, we people speak lot and lot of sentence in our day-to-day life. The words which we use to make a sentence plays a very important role in the formation of the sentence. These words have their own use and have their own work in the sentence, and these words are known as the parts of speech. There are 8 parts of speech. First is noun, second pronoun, third adjective, fourth verb, sixth adverb, fifth adverb, sixth preposition, seventh conjunction, eighth interjection. Among these 8 parts of speech, we have already done first 4 parts of speech, that is noun, pronoun, adjective and verb, in our previous video. And now we will be covering the last 4 parts of the parts of speech, that are adverb, preposition, conjunction, interjection. So let's get started. Adverb. An adverb is a word that says something more about the verb. And adjective, the words which tell us more and more things about a verb. And an adjective are known as the adverb. Let's have a look on the examples. In the first example is I spoke politely. I spoke politely. In this sentence, politely will be our adverb and spoke will be our verb. Okay, now moving towards the next sentence. This building is very beautiful. In this sentence, very will be our very will be our adverb. Very will be our adverb and beautiful will be our adjective. Beautiful will be our adjective. Moving towards the next sentence. I spoke quite politely. In this sentence, the word quite is adverb. The word quite is adverb. And word politely is also an adverb. Okay, now moving towards the next part of speech, that is preposition. Okay, a preposition is a word used with a noun or a pronoun. A word used with a noun or a pronoun to show how noun and pronoun stands by or stands in relation to something. This means the words which shows the relationship of noun or pronoun with other words of the sentence is called preposition. Okay, preposition can be of put into onto with okay on above of under. Okay, now let's have a look on the examples of preposition. First example is the books are on the table. In this sentence, our preposition will be on, as it is showing us the relationship between the books and the table. Now moving towards the second sentence, the sky is above us. In this sentence, our preposition will be above, as it is showing us the relationship between the sky and us. Moving towards the next sentence, he is fond of reading. In this sentence, our preposition will be of, as it is showing the relationship between he and reading. Now moving towards the another sentence, we rested under a tree. In this sentence, our preposition will be under, as it is showing us the relationship between we and a tree. Is that clear? Now moving towards the next part of speech, that is conjunction. What do you mean by conjunction? A conjunction is a word that is used to join two sentences, two clauses, two phrases together. Let's have a look on the examples. First example is home and office. In this phrase, this is a phrase. We cannot say this a sentence. This is a phrase. In this phrase, and is conjunction because it is joining two words. It is joining two phrases, that is home and office. Okay, moving towards the next example, at home but not in the office. At home but not in the office. In this phrase, but will be our conjunction because it is joining two phrases, at home and not in the office. Moving towards the next example, if you work hard and if you are sincere. In this, our conjunction will be and, because it is joining two clauses, that is if you work hard, if you are sincere. Okay, Moving towards the next example, I went to the market but did could not get the books. I went to the market but I could not get the books. In this sentence, our conjunction will be but, because it is joining two sentences, that is, I went to the market but I could not get the books is a sentence. Okay, now moving towards the last part of speech, that is interjection. Interjection. An interjection is a word which expresses certain feeling, sorrow or surprise. The words which are used to express the certain feeling, sorrow or joy of a human being is known as the interjection. Let's move towards the example. First example is hurrah means happiness. Hurrah, we won the match. Hurrah means joy, happiness. We won the match. Moving towards the next sentence. Alas, alas, her only son died. Her only son dead. This is showing us the feeling of sorrow, sadness. And it's showing us the expression of sadness that her only son is dead. Now, moving towards the exercise of the parts of speech. Read the following sentences, underline the word or words that belongs to the parts of speech as given in the bracket. Okay, you in this exercise you are given some sentences, and in front of that sentences you are given some parts of speech, and according to that part of speech you have to underline in the sentence. Okay, moving towards the first sentence. Do you like dogs? In this sentence you have to find the verb, you have to underline the verb. The verb will be like. Okay, they listen to music every day. They listen to music every day. In this sentence you have to find out the verb. The verb will be listen. Okay, is she an old lady? In this sentence you have to find out the adjective. The adjective will be old lady. What will be the adjective? Old lady. Moving towards the next sentence, the group went climbing in the mountains. You have to find out the noun. The noun will be group. Moving towards the next sentence, this is a fast car. This is a fast car. In this sentence, you have to find out the adjective. Okay? The adjective will be fast. Moving towards the next sentence, he did well in the test. In this sentence, we have to find out the adverb. So, our adverb will be well. What would be our adverb? Well. Okay. My father drives carefully. In this sentence also, we have to find out the adverb. So, the adverb will be carefully. Okay. Moving towards the next sentence. Has your father ever been to Australia? In this sentence you have to find out noun. The noun will be father. Okay, moving towards the last sentence of this exercise. The play was fantastic. In this sentence you have to find out the noun. What will be the noun? Play. Okay, thank you. you for watching my video. Like, share, comment and subscribe.